student, because of technical glitch, that video was, because of some reason, it got paused, or you can say it was totally disconnected. So I want to continue from here. So sincerely, what I said, that if you have no idea what to write, sincerely, faithfully, truly, so go with one simple word, that is truly. I don't think so that I have to write it for you. Okay, you can understand. Simply, you have to write truly, and you have to finish up your letter. Yeah, you have to write, you have to give your signature. Most of the students like to give autograph, so give your autograph, that is your choice. Write, but what personally I prefer, write your name. Or if you are giving your autograph, just below that, mention your name with your surname. And then your letter is end. Now, one more trick to make your letter very neat and clean. Like you can see the copy margin. This is the copy margin, okay? So from here I have written the letter. You can see I have just followed one after the other. So what you have to do, because you don't, means you are not able to do this, your hands just detangle here and there. So sometimes you write sender address here, then you write date here, then you write receiver's address here. So instead of doing that, what you will do, you will make one faint line with pencil and then touch that line and go on writing this. What does this make? It will be in one straight line and it will look really very neat and clean. So this is your formal letter. So please go through it. And one more thing, I said that for some addresses that you can write and you can use it in your all examinations when there is no detail. So for sender address, one address I am giving you, if you want to write, you can write. Like you can write this. Like I am writing and also I am mentioning it. I will say it. Georgetown is there in Delhi or not, but still you can just go with it. And still, if you have any doubts, then you can comment there and you can ask with me the question. I'll answer to your questions. Thank you.